Okay, in this video we continue with our discussion on characterization of trees. The last two videos we proved first two implications. So we already proved 1 implies 2 and 2 implies 3. Okay, so in this video we will prove 3 implies 4. Okay, so that says if this is a connected graph and the number of vertices is equal to number of vertices plus 1, then G is acyclic and n equal to m plus 1. Okay, so let's go and prove that implication. 3 implies 4. Okay. So the statement reads as follows: if G is a connected graph and n equal to m plus 1, then G is acyclic and n equal to m plus 1. Okay, so let's prove this implication. Okay, so assume that G is connected and the number of vertices is equal to number of edges plus 1. Okay, so assume that G is connected and n equal to m plus 1. Okay, so this part is already there, n equal to m plus 1. Okay, so only need to prove that G is acyclic. Okay, so our goal here is to prove that G is acyclic and n equal to m plus 1. Okay. Okay, so here again we assume that G has a cycle and that will lead to a contradiction. Okay, so for the sake of getting a contradiction, suppose that G contains a cycle of length k. Okay, so if you look into this cycle, then that cycle has length k. That says the number of vertices and number of edges in that cycle is k. Okay, so there are k vertices and k edges on that cycle. Okay, so suppose that this is that cycle. Okay, so next what we are going to do is we are going to fix a vertex u on this cycle, and we are going to consider another vertex v, okay, that is not on this cycle, and we consider this uv path. Okay, and while considering this uv path, we consider the shortest path between this u and v. Okay, and we look on this edge, okay, on last edge on this path that is directly connected to v. Okay, and that is unique only to this v because we are dealing with the shortest uv path. Okay, and that is true for any other vertex. Okay. In this graph, okay, that is not on this cycle. Okay, this particular thing is true for all other vertices, all other, okay, in this case n minus k vertices. Okay, and let's see what is going to happen. So, okay, so there are k vertices and k edges on this cycle, and let's consider a point on this cycle. Okay, so fix a vertex u on the cycle. Okay, and let's consider another vertex which is not on this cycle. Okay, so let's consider any one of the remaining n minus k vertices not on the cycle. And let that vertex be say V. Okay. And since G is connected, so that is given in the hypothesis. G is connected. Okay. Since G is connected, there is a UV path, and let's consider the shortest UV path. Okay. In graph G, since G is connected, there is a shortest in G. The situation is something like this. Okay, we consider this cycle of length k, and we fix a vertex on this cycle, and let's take a vertex which doesn't belong to this cycle. And since the graph is connected, there is a shortest path between this U and V. Okay. So since this is connected, there is a shortest UV path in G. Okay, so let's consider an edge. Okay, as I said, so what we are going to do is we are going to consider this edge which is directly connected to V. Okay, consider edge on this path that shortest path incident with V. Okay, so this is a unique edge that is incident with V, right? Okay, and similarly for each vertex, there is such an edge. So consider the edge on this UV path incident on V. So this is for an arbitrary vertex V, and this is true for every other vertex, okay, that is not on the cycle. Okay, consider the edge. Okay, so that means the remaining or this n minus k, so one such edge is this one. Similarly for every other n minus k vertex, we can find a unique edge incident with that vertex. Okay, the n minus k edges thus obtained are all distinct. Okay, so we have those k edges on the cycle, and we have these n minus k unique edges. Okay, the graph may have many other edges, but here we can see that if we assume something like this, this graph has a cycle. Okay, then that says therefore the number of edges, okay, is greater than or equal to this n minus k plus k. This k edges obtained from that cycle, and this n minus k unique edges obtained this way, and the graph could have more edges. Okay, that's why we have this condition m greater than or equal to n minus k plus k. Okay, and this says okay m is greater than or equal to n. Okay, and this is a contradiction too. So here we assume something like this is connected and n equal to m plus 1. Okay, so okay, this is a contradiction. N equal to m plus 1. Okay, so that says our assumption is wrong. Okay, so we assume something like this. This contains a cycle of length k, okay, and that says the graph is acyclic. So hence G is acyclic and has n equal to m plus 1 vertices. Okay, so that's the proof for this implication. Okay, and that's the proof for this implication 3 implies 4. Okay, so now we proved 1 implies 2, 2 implies 3, and 3 implies 4. Okay, so the remaining implication that is to be proved is 4 implies 1. Okay, so that we will prove in the next video. So if you are able to prove this thing also, we can say that all these four statements are equivalent by using this circular kind of implication. Okay, so here we proved 3 implies 4. In the next video we will prove 4 implies 1.